Protesters in Beirut, Lebanon, stormed the offices of the Environment Ministry yesterday in the latest dramatic action of a growing anti-government movement. A fluid campaign under the hashtag #YouStink is taking the government to task for not picking up trash for several weeks, stemming from a dispute over a landfill. The protesters have demanded the resignation of the Environment Minister, Mohamed Majnouk. The occupation of the Environment Ministry came on the heels of a major demonstration in central Beirut on Saturday, at which thousands of people showed up. In late July, hundreds of students and others were injured when security forces used live ammunition and tear gas to disperse protesters. But the rot has deeper roots than just a garbage crisis. Anger over political stagnation and corruption began as early as July. The government is unable to elect a new parliament and president. Joining me now live from Lebanon is Jackson Allers. He's a journalist, filmmaker, and writer based in Beirut. Welcome to Uprising, Jackson.
Thank you, Sonali.
Now, what has happened at the Environment Ministry since yesterday? There were threats to clear the offices, but protesters said that they wouldn't leave. We saw a lot of videos on social media from people who were occupying those premises, and they were sitting down. They didn't look like they were going to move.
Well, indeed, they were forced to leave, but against their will, of course. And it did get violent. One of the lead protest organizers, Lucien Bourgeli, actually sustained injuries after he was forcibly removed yesterday from the offices. They've essentially taken that as momentum to move it into the next round of demonstrations and protests. As it stands right now, the interior minister, who is another Majnouk, actually Nohad Majnouk, has said that it's unwise for the protesters to actually try to do this again, that they would basically see the brunt of the security forces enforcibly removing any protesters that decide to do this again, which is that's kind of a strategy that I would say the organizers are employing, in part because they need to show that the state and the government actors and the leaders themselves are essentially negating their cries for them to step down, especially Mohamed Majnouk, the environment minister, who has been woefully handling the trash crisis as it's come up this summer. So they were forced out of the offices of Mohamed Majnouk yesterday, but not without a lot of media attention and not without a lot of, let's say, support being galvanized, not just within Lebanon, but around the world.